And we begin with new developments in the volcanic emergency on the Big Island. Another community is now being forced to evacuate. This time it is homes along Ala'ili Road. That is in the southwest portion of Leilani Estates. That area now being cleared over fears of a possible new fissure that, if open, would cut off the only road in and out of the community if the flow goes over the asphalt. We'll have more on that in a moment, but first, another hazard that could be on the horizon. Officials are now preparing for the possibility of an explosive steam event at Halema'uma'u Crater in a matter of days. That's inside the park. Now, because of that, most of the Hawaiian Volcanoes National Park will be closed on Friday, including the Jagger Museum, which overlooks the lava lake, and the Kilauea Visitor Center, and campgrounds as well. Today we saw thick, billowing smoke out of the crater, but as scary as that looks, that's not the type of explosion that officials are worried about. That one would be much more dangerous. The huge plumes of ash that kept coming throughout the day were the result of rockfalls within the Halema'uma'u Crater. But those rockfalls could lead to larger and more dangerous explosive events as the lava lake inside of the crater continues to drop lower.
And so one of the concerns is if the lava lake continues to drop and it drops below the water table, instead of these gas-driven explosions like we're seeing now, we could get into a situation where the water from the groundwater below the water table could mix in with the magma, and then we would have these steam-driven explosions.
This diagram shows what she means. Like the neck of a soda bottle, the rocks can form a cap, and with enough mixing, the pressure comes, and then the explosion.
Very similar to what happened in March of 2008. We got the first blast out. Same thing, the conduit had been blocked by debris.
It was similar to what happened in 1924 when there were these large explosions, and those are more vigorous and there's more energy involved, and so larger fragments can be blown out and greater distances.
In 1924, an explosion at the crater sent a boulder as large as a car flying into the air. That shouldn't happen here, and that type of debris wouldn't be a threat to neighboring communities, other than perhaps the immediate area around the crater. One thing that could impact residents, however, is the volcanic ash. Again, back in 1924, in that explosion, records show that ash came down as far north as Hilo, Pahala, even Maku'u.
It is not in itself a life-threatening phenomenon. It's an irritant, it's a nuisance, especially if it goes on for many weeks. Generally speaking, it's prudent to avoid exposure during an ash fall if you can, but again, it's not life-threatening to be in a fine ash fall.
And there you were listening to Tina Neal, who's the lead geologist in charge there. She was speaking at the community meeting tonight at the Volcanoes National Park. Now, here's some other interesting facts you want to know in the event of an explosion. First, according to experts, there's a chance for a strong earthquake in the area and, of course, aftershocks. But because it's so far inland, a tsunami is not likely. The explosion itself only could last a couple of minutes. However, the ash cloud that it creates could last much longer. In the past, it has stuck around for weeks, but officials say there's just no way to know for sure.